We're going to look at a summing amplifier with and without bias current correction. First, let's look at the version of the summing amplifier without bias current correction. A summing amplifier is a type of op-amp circuit that you can use when you want to sum different voltages together. For example, if we want to know what voltage VA plus voltage VB is, but we don't want to affect either of those two voltages too much, then we can use a summing amplifier. You can see here that in our formula for the output voltage, we have VA plus VB, and we have controllable constants in front of both VA and VB. Let me show you how this circuit works. Because the non-inverting pin is grounded, we know that the voltage here at the inverting pin should also be 0 volts. Let's call this current I sub A. Let's call this current I sub B, and let's call this current I sub F. Applying the Kirchhoff current law at the node at the inverting terminal of the op-amp, we know that those currents have to sum to zero, or equivalently, I sub F has to equal I sub A plus I sub B. We can use Ohm's law to find all of these currents. I sub F is minus V out over R sub F. I sub A is VA over RA, and I sub B is VB over R sub B. Multiplying everything times minus RF immediately allows us to solve for the output voltage in terms of the inputs. Although the summing amplifier that I've shown here only has two inputs, V sub A and V sub B, I hope you can realize by glancing at the circuit that you could have many more inputs, and the circuit would simply take the sum of all of them. The basis of the operation of the summing amplifier is the Kirchhoff current law. The resistors here at the input side effectively convert current into voltage. So the Kirchhoff current law allows you to take the sum of currents, and then the resistors here allow you to take effectively the sum of the voltages. I mentioned that this circuit doesn't have bias correction, so let's go ahead and add it in and make a slightly improved version of the summing amplifier. We're going to be including a bias resistor at the non-inverting input. The purpose of the bias resistor is to eliminate the effect of any I sub B on the calculation of the output voltage. In the last circuit, I effectively assumed that this bias current I sub B equals zero. That's a reasonable approximation if your input signals are not too small, but if your input signals to be amplified, or summed in this case, are not really very large, then you might want to make this correction. Let's label the voltage here V. It's not going to be zero anymore. The same voltage is going to be present here in the circuit. Let's call this current IA and apply Ohm's law in order to find it. We have voltage VA on the left side of that resistor and V on the right. Let's call this current I sub B and again apply Ohm's law across resistor RB in order to find it. Applying Ohm's law across my bias resistor, V equals minus R bias times IB. Let's call the current through the feedback resistor I sub F and again apply Ohm's law in order to find it. We have V on the left side and V out on the right side. As in the last problem, the key of the summing amplifier is the fact that the Kirchhoff current law is applied at this node. Let's go ahead and apply the Kirchhoff current law. We know that current in has to equal current out. Therefore, IA plus IB has to equal IB plus IF. There's only a slight modification here in the analysis compared to the version of the circuit without the bias resistor. I intend to find the output voltage here in terms of the input voltage, but I'm going to start off by assuming that I've made the correct choice of the bias resistor. What will that correct choice result in? My goal here is to eliminate IB in the expression for the output voltage. In other words, if my inputs are all zero, then I expect my output also to be zero. I don't want there to be an I sub B in that expression. Therefore, let's take this equation and assume that my inputs are turned off. We'll start with IA. Turning off my input, I'm just left with minus V over RA. Now let's look at input I sub B. Turning off my input V sub B, I'm just left with minus V over R sub B. I can't turn off my bias current. That's the problem that we're trying to eliminate. Finally, I have my expression for I sub F. It doesn't contain any of the inputs, so there's nothing to turn off here. Now let's look at my goal. If the inputs are turned off, then what do I want to achieve? I want to achieve that the output is zero. So let me force the output voltage to be zero and then find the necessary voltage V in order to make that happen. I'm now going to rewrite that expression and substitute in the expression here for the bias resistor. I can take every term in this equation and divide it by R bias. What I've done is effectively derived the correct value for the bias resistor in order to eliminate the effect of the bias current on my expression for the output voltage. Once that's done, the derivation of the expression for the output voltage itself becomes identical to that done for the circuit without the bias correction. What we've done in this video is to look at two different versions of a summing amplifier. That is, an amplifier that takes various voltages as the inputs, multiplies them times predetermined constants, and gives you an answer as the sum of those terms. We've looked at two different versions of the summing amplifier, one without input bias current correction, and a slightly improved version with that correction.